Hello and welcome to HanaMate. In this short video, I want to introduce you to some of my basic junk journaling supplies. So junk journaling, as the name gives it away, it's basically you're creating journals out of whatever scraps you have. However, it is nice if you have some very basic supplies. So here's my tote. I will be basically unpacking it and showing you what supplies I use. However, there are no limits. You can use tons of different supplies. So this is a paper dolly. They're fantastic to attach to make kind of old-fashioned look. This is a cardstock. Scrapbooking paper is great and you can get it for a really good deal. Plus, you can cut it in regular size. It makes it very easy. So I use cardstock and this is a paper, thin one. The really great part about the scrapbooking paper is that usually there are about three sets or three times two pages of paper that match somehow. When I make my journaling pages, I like to do at least three similar or matching colors and patterns per page. I also use tissue paper and old maps. You can also use old paper bags. I like this type of tape, actually. It works great. This is my special gallotine, gallows. I love this cutter very much. Yes, I have two. I do share sometimes. You can share blades on that cutter, by the way. That's why I love it. Then I love using stamps. They do add so much. Then you need, of course, stamp pad. You can also use the cleaning pad. I use glue, any type of glue, but in this case I did bought glue in plastic. The ribbons are fantastic. Then if you come across any kind of books with cool artsy quotes, they do add lots of touch. Of course, it depends on the theme of your journal. I carry a few samples of journals because I like to show it to people what I'm doing. And these are different samples with different binding. This is right now my favorite. I actually was fortunate to receive a binding machine, so I use it. As I mentioned, I use paper bags as well, either as pages or embellishments, but I also always have one next to me for trash. It just makes sense to me. Post-it notes are fantastic for adding any kind of write-up or quotes or whatever. These are awesome, actually. I love those bubble-shaped ones. Another journal that I made long time ago. I also have one just to practice different pages layouts. There's more tissue paper. If you get lucky, you can find in stores always two matching ones. Stickers, of course, and then you can get whatever different quotes. These are on vellum. They were great. I carry extra scissors, hole punchers, and they just are very practical and you can use them for making the binding too. Different corners and scrapbooking supplies are fantastic. If you ever see them in thrift stores, don't hesitate to grab them. I also have little pencil case with different pens and pencils and erasers, whatever I can use. Ooh, I have actually two. Told you I like to share. those are actually oil pastels. They were fantastic for shadowing. Eyeglasses are definitely reading glasses. Very helpful. and then I carry a little bit of makeup, not for myself, but for shadowing and aging pages. And what else do I have there? More scissors and too many pockets and another pencil. And I think that's it. Oh, another treasure. This is my favorite box. So that's kind of the last stage of finishing pages. I have lots of different scraps of small papers and stickers and little flags and cutouts. So I just wanted to show you very briefly what my supplies are. I am playing with junk journaling a lot now, and if you want to be inspired, you can join me on Facebook or Instagram. But there's tons of material from other people who really know what they are doing. All right, thank you for watching, HanaMate.